So this quiz was probably a little tricky to answer based on just what I've told you so far. And the picture might be a little deceptive, but I hope you thought about this from the perspective of constructing a program. The answer that I think is correct is that it's not the case that all modules should be of similar size. It's okay if they are, like shown in the picture, but this shouldn't be a big design constraint. It's okay if the sizes vary, and in a typical program, we'll have some small modules and some larger ones. The second answer is true. Our goal in using modularity is manage complexity. So we want to break the program into pieces small enough that one programmer can understand and build them. Note that if we're dealing with a very large program, this may require hierarchy. We might need modules of modules. The third answer is incorrect. If there are no dependencies at all between the modules, well, that means they're not working together. In order for the modules to work together, there has to be some connections between them. What we want is for those dependencies to be manageable. We want there to be small, well-defined interfaces between the modules. That means that in order to use one module, what we need to understand about that module is as little as possible, but enough to be able to use it to build something useful. And that's going to be one of the main things we focus on in this lesson. One of the advantages of having narrow, well-defined interfaces is we can separate the implementation from the use of the module. That if we have some other way of implementing this piece, well, we could still plug it in, and we wouldn't need to change the green piece at all. That's one of our goals of modular design, to be able to plug in different modules without having to reconsider the whole system.